Hi, in this demo, we're going to show the proof of reserve feature of the stablecoin studio. Why would we want proof of reserve on a stablecoin? Well, primarily to avoid under-collateralization. This is to make sure that whenever the token is minted, the amount that is being minted is properly collateralized by fiat in reserve or any other collateral that may sustain or support the stablecoin. The other desirable feature of proof of reserve is transparency. So ideally, we'd like to see on-chain data to indicate that the reserve for a stablecoin are sufficient. And this may also guide your decision to acquire some stablecoin if you're able to determine that the collateralization is above the amount in circulation. And finally, it would be best if this was automated. So how does this work? First of all, on the top left, we have off-chain assets. These could be held in a bank account, gold in a vault. It's any off-chain assets that are underpinning the stablecoin itself. Those assets are monitored by an oracle or by another process. As an oracle, whenever it notices a change in the balance of the off-chain assets, it will update a smart contract called a reserve contract. This reserve contract basically holds the latest balance for the off-chain assets. Whenever a stablecoin, depending on these assets, is minted, this will trigger a smart contract, which will check the balance held in that reserve contract. The outcome of that check could be that the token is over-collateralized, or at least sufficiently collateralized, and in which case the minting operation will succeed. On the other hand, if the reserve contract states that the newly minted amount is below the amount in reserve, then the token would be considered under-collateralized and therefore the minting operation would fail. So let's see this in operation. Here I have the CLI tool for Stablecoin Studio, and we're going to deploy a stablecoin with proof of reserve. So I'll choose my issuer user. I'm going to create a new stablecoin and I will call it POR coin. Give it a symbol, POR, and we're going to skip through the bulk of the settings here, just sticking with defaults, except for proof of reserve when we get there. So here we go. Do we want to use proof of reserve? And the answer here is yes. We don't yet have an existing proof of reserve contract, but we could here link to an existing contract that serves this purpose. In this instance, we'll say no, and this will deploy a new contract for us to act as the reserve contract. And we'll start with an initial amount of 1,000 tokens in reserve, and we'll just say yes to all of the other questions. And we're now ready to create our token. So let's go ahead with that. So now the token is created, let's check its details to verify that our proof of reserve is indeed set up properly. And we can see down here at the bottom that we have indeed a reserve address, which is the smart contract that will act as reserve for us, and a reserve amount of 1,000. So given this reserve of 1,000, we should be able to cash in some tokens. We'll cash in to 01092, which is another account of mine, and we'll cash in 900. Cash in is the equivalent of mint in the stablecoin studio. So the transaction was successful. We can now check the total supply against reserve, and we can see that we have a total supply of 900 tokens and our reserve amount is still 1000. So let's now try and cash in an extra 200 tokens, taking us above reserve. Clearly, the operation failed here. The reserve amount is less than the current total supply plus the amount that we wanted to cash in. So let's now go through the flow where we would update the reserve amount. I have a couple of scripts here that I've written, and I will paste in the contract ID for the reserve contract. And we're basically specifying here that the amount should be 200,000. Note that because we're representing fiat in this case, we have two decimals for the reserve. So we're really setting the reserve to be 2,000 tokens. We're going to call the reserve contract with its function set amount to set this new reserve amount. Let's go ahead and do that. So as we can see, the script is telling us that the reserve amount has been updated. We're able to check this is correct with this other script here, which again calls the same smart contract, and it queries a function on the contract called latest round data. This is using the implementation specified by Chainlink for proof of reserve, and in querying this smart contract for latest round data, we'll get to see the amount in reserve. And indeed, the contract is telling us that the amount in the reserve is now 2,000 tokens. First of all, we'll check that the CLI agrees with what we've just done through the scripts, and the new reserve amount is indeed 2,000. So let's try to cash in again. If you remember last time, we tried to cash in 200 and that failed. So we should now be able to do so because we've increased reserve. And indeed, the transaction was successful. So that completes the proof of reserve demo, where we've shown you how to create a token with proof of reserve enabled. We've successfully cashed in below reserve. We then failed to cash in above reserve. We updated the reserve amounts, and finally, we could cash in successfully thanks to the updated reserve amounts.